यू सीइंग द बोर्ड चिल्ड्रन?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What you are seeing, can you read? What you are seeing, can you read? Are you able to read?
Chapter 10,
International Business
Studies. Chapter 10, International Business. First, meaning. International business means business activities taking place beyond the geographical limits. That means business, simply we can say business between two or more countries. That's a simple meaning. Business between two or more countries. Two or more will come. I will tell why it is two or more. You see it. The business between two or more countries is called an international business. Then, coming to the features. The feature is already in the meaning I wrote on the board. What's the first feature? Did you take the book, children? Test book. It should be opened.
Sir, in countries.
What's the first feature?
Involves two countries.
Just a minute. Oh, sir. Question paper class le irukku sir, question paper or 15 minutes before I will finish and study, sir. Okay. So what is the first feature, children? Did you take the book? Tell me,
did you take the book?
Did you take the book?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what's the first feature?
Involves two countries.
Two or
she is given in that book two, but actually two or more. You should try like that. Or more countries. Purchasing goods from one country is called import. Selling goods to other country is called export. Purchasing goods from one country and selling goods to some other country, it is called an import. In that case, three countries are involved. Once again, purchasing goods from one country is called purchasing goods from a foreign country. Purchasing goods from a foreign country is called import. Selling goods to a foreign country.
Import.
Selling goods to foreign country.
Export.
Another trade. Purchasing goods from one country. I mean one foreign country. Selling goods to some other country. Best example. An Indian businessman is purchasing goods from London and selling the goods to Myanmar. You know Myanmar? Old Burma. Or neighboring country only. It's called end report.
Yes, sir.
So in this case, how many countries are involved? India, Great Britain, and Myanmar. That is why I told you.
Myanmar.
The best expression is not two countries, two or more countries. What is second point? Use of foreign currency.
Use of foreign currency. So involving three countries' names, sir.
So for example, Indian businessman buying goods from London and selling those goods to Myanmar. So in that case, three countries are involved: India, Great Britain. London is not a country. Okay. London is
like
not
import, a export, any name, sir.
Third one, end report. End report. ENTRE keyword.
Yes,
okay. Okay. Use of foreign currency. When two countries are trading, trading means conducting business. Generally, the medium of exchange is dollar. That is a commonly accepted currency. Once again, when two or more countries are trading each other, the common currency, they have to use some common currency acceptable in all countries. So only very few currencies are common. First currency is US dollar. Second only euro. Indian rupees is acceptable. Indian rupees is not acceptable in all countries. Only in few countries. Okay. So they will select one common currency called US dollar. What's the third one? Third one.
Legal obligations.
Legal obligation. Are you writing along with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Legal obligation. When two or more countries are involved, both these business people have to accept some formalities. These formalities are called rules and regulations. It is not easy to export something to another country. It is not that much easy to import goods from other country. They will check the goods. When you are exporting something to foreign country, first of all, their foreign country's representative will be in all over the countries. Every country will be having their own representative. Okay? So they will be checking. After reaching the goods also, they will check. Customs duty we have to pay. Whether are you having the license to export or import, all these formalities. It's not tedious, but simply we have to follow that. It's not difficult. There is no difficulties in that. Some formalities has to be followed. Rules and regulations. Every country will be having certain rules. Certain country are having some restrictions. We cannot import goods. We cannot export certain goods. Certain countries will not accept certain goods from some countries. So before you are entering into import or export, what are the rules and regulations you have to study well? What's the fourth point? What's the fourth one, children?
High degree of risk.
So note down these headings.
High degree of risks.
And send the images for classwork, otherwise zero mark. High degree of risk. What is a risk in accountancy we learned? What is risk? It is in accountancy also, in business studies also. Risk means possibility of loss.
Earning profit.
Not earning profits. Risk means the possibility of incurring loss, chance of loss, we can say. Simply we can say chance of loss. Risk means
chance of
sir,
loss.
But we can say to gain profit we have to take risk, no sir.
What was the question? I asked the meaning of risk. If you want to earn profit, you have to take risk. Question was, what's the meaning of risk? I didn't ask the purpose of business. Question was, what's the meaning of risk? Purpose of business is to earn profit. That was not the question. Question was, what was the meaning of risk? What's the meaning of risk? Chance of loss. Possibility of
loss.
If you are not ready to take risk, you cannot earn anything. No risk, yes, no risk, no gain. No pain, no gain. No pain, no gain. If you are not ready to take pain, you cannot gain also. If you want to gain something, you have to sacrifice something. You should be ready to face any eventualities, any hardships, any difficulties, any accidents, unforeseen events. You cannot escape. When you are facing some problem in business, don't try to close the business. And we can reduce the risk in many ways. Insurance is the commonly accepted way to reduce risk. Suppose there is fire in the business, unexpectedly, fire occurs. If you are not having insurance, you have to close the business immediately. If you are having the insurance, how you will manage? How you will manage? You will be getting insurance amount from the insurance company. For that, you have to pay monthly premium. It's not a big amount. You should be able to anticipate. So that was related to first three chapters, that is over. Here, high degree of risk. What is the risk associated with foreign business, international business, foreign trade? See, when the goods are reaching in our country, or when the goods are reaching in some other country, by the time there is chance of destroying the goods because of many reasons. Climatic condition, certain goods are not exportable also. Certain goods we have to export within few hours, otherwise it will be damaged. So if it is transported in ship, there is chance of colliding two ships may be collided, goods may be destroyed. If some tsunami comes, the ship itself will be disappeared. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
And the value of the currency may be fluctuating. So this kind of risk are there. What is the fifth point?
Heavy documentation.
Yes. We note down the points, these headings. You have to give a small explanation after reading that textbook. I give you the explanation. Heavy documentation. See, just like any other business, can you imagine what are the procedures? Some documentations are extra. Procedures for foreign trade also same like local trade, domestic trade. Some extra work is there. Can you say what are the procedures first when you are doing a business? You cannot force anybody to buy the goods. You have to get order from somebody. So the first step is receiving order. Can you force anybody to buy the goods? Is it possible?
No, sir.
So you have to create that temptation to buy the goods or services through the advertisements. You can persuade the customer, not forcefully. After seeing the advertisement or seeing the advertisement, customer should be coming forward willingly, not forcefully. Then they will give the order, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Are you there or simply your names are appearing, nobody is in the class? Is it like that?
There, sir.
First of all, we have to receive the order. Receiving the order is the first step. After receiving order, what's the next step, children? After receiving the order, we can sleep. Money will come, isn't it? Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Very good, students. It should be like this. After receiving the order, we can go and sleep. We will get the money. Money will be credited in our bank. That is business, right?
So we have to sell the goods.
We have to sell. Before selling, what we have to do? We have to arrange the goods according to the order. Which model they want, which brand they want, how many quantities they want. According to the model and description, we have to arrange the goods. After that, what we have to do? If you are exporting, we have to arrange many documents from the concerned departments. Bill of lading is there. Many documents are there. Bill of exchange is there. Shipping document is there. And they will be asking the invoices. If you are selling, I mean, if you are exporting, you have to show the export invoice. If you are importing, you have to show the import invoice. Many documents are there. And the department will be making sure that goods exported or imported are not dangerous. Many certificates from where you are buying to where you are exporting, everything is documented. What the different documentations are there? Since documentations are more, we are using the term heavy documentation. Okay, what's the next step?
Time consuming.
This is time consuming. Sixth point is time consuming. In a local trade, I mean domestic trade, I mean trade within the country, it won't take much time to send the goods or get the payment. But in foreign trade, it will take more time. For reaching the goods in the destination, it will take some time. Getting the payments, for getting the payment, it will take some more time. So that's one more thing is there. Lack of, what's the seventh point?
Lack of personal contact.
See, you may not be knowing to whom you are saying. Only through document we are understanding. We are not seeing the person. And they are not seeing you. You are communicating without seeing each other. Nowadays, this problem is solved through many technological aspects. WhatsApp. Nowadays, you can communicate with a person by seeing. I am seeing you. You are seeing me. When the book is written, this technology was not famous. Now it is popular. If I want to see you, I can see you. If you want to see me, it is possible. You can see me. So for exam purpose, you can write like this. But keep in mind, that is not the major feature. Lack of personal contacts. Live contact is possible. You cannot touch the person, but you can see and talk. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
The features are over. I'm going to the next topic. What's the next topic? Reasons for
international business.
Are you writing the points?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Reasons for international trade. What's the first reason?
Money and distribution of natural resources.
And distribution of natural resources.
Uneven distribution of natural resources. Uneven. Uneven distribution of natural resources. Actually, the meaning is already in the word, in the heading. Uneven. What do you mean uneven? Unequal. Unequal. See, a product available in India is not available in Pakistan. In Pakistan, it is difficult to cultivate vegetables. What may be the reason? What may be the reason? Climatic condition. Okay. Quality of soil. Availability of manure. Water supply. See, all these things are favorable in India. The fruits which are produced in America, those fruits we cannot cultivate in India. What may be the reason? Hello?
Climate.
Yes, climate. Main thing, climate. Second thing, quality of soil. So the natural resources are not distributed equally. That means it is not available and available everywhere. Certain things which are available in, certain things are available only in some countries. That also in some parts. Apple and grapes are cultivated more in Jammu and Kashmir. It is not cultivated in Kerala. What is the reason?
Because of the climate
because of the climate and soil. But we can cultivate those things in Ooty and Kodaikanal. What is the reason? Climate is almost same, just like Jammu and Kashmir.
So because nearly
Many fruits which are grown in Jammu and Kashmir is grown in Ooty and Kodaikanal also. Because of the climate. At least for some months, Ooty and Kodaikanal is favorable for cultivation of apples. So, like that, goods available in some countries or in some parts of the countries are not available in some other parts or in some other countries. So, countries have to depend each other. That's the reason for, that's the first reason for international trade. Are you understanding, children? Okay, what is the second reason? The second reason?
Availability of factors of production.
Yes. What are the factors of production? You have learned in economics also, right? What are the factors of production? Factors of production.
That means the
requirements for production.
Materials.
Yes. To produce something, first of all, we want the money. Without money, is it possible to do any business, children?
No, sir.
Yeah. After money, after arranging money, what is the next step? Labor. There should be?
Land.
Labor.
Land should be there. Land should be available. People who know how to do the work, labor force, skilled labor, unskilled labor.
Skilled labor.
Material. The technology, any things are there. These things are also not available in some countries. There are many poor countries there, they cannot do any business. They don't have money. In some countries, they have money, but labor is not available. In India, almost everything is possible because our labor force is more than the requirement. But the one problem is there, the qualification acquired by the labor is not proportionate to the requirements. See, for the next 30 years, we want more commerce students. But I don't think that more admission will be the for commerce because many parents are ignorant about this fact. They are simply sending their children for science. Actually, there is more than enough. We have more than enough scientists and engineers. Still, they are sending their children for science. We want lakhs and lakhs of commerce graduates, but the number is less. We are qualified, but our qualification is not matching with the requirements. Are you getting my point, children?
Yes,
that is the reason the salary is less for many categories. When there is a job vacancy, A vacancy at all, A vacancy, A job vacancy, that means one vacancy. Thousands of people are applying. Who created the situation? We only created, right? So when we are selecting a course, make sure that it is useful. Otherwise, waste of money. Okay. What is the number three, children?
Specialization.
Specialization. See, certain countries are blessed with certain things. For example, jute production. You know jute production? Jute. Many jute products are there. Jute socks.
Yes, sir.
Jute kayak. See, it is not possible to cultivate jute everywhere in India. It is cultivated more in West Bengal. You know West Bengal? In our state, in our country, West Bengal. Yes. West Bengal is the place where jute cultivation is more. That area is blessed. Potato is also growing more in West Bengal. You know that? Potato? Urulakalanga. Potato is also growing more in West Bengal. That soil and the climate is more favorable. One more thing is there. What is that? Number four?
Cost benefits.
In certain countries, some products can be produced from our best example is China. Electronic goods are produced at cheap rate in China. What may be the reason? Any foreign companies are settled in China. What may be the reason? Nowadays, after Corona,
so because the every things available to it, like raw material are there, sir.
Labor cost is very less. Salary for the staff is very, very less. And with the less salary, they can live in China. Cost of living is less to some extent. But in India, with that much salary, it is difficult to survive in India.